Hello, welcome to the next video in our series. So this video we're going to be looking at Gatsby Benchmark 4, which we've both kind of agreed, haven't we, David? This is one of our favourite benchmarks in terms of, you know, how we like to support schools.
So
do you want to kick us off? You know, what is the benchmark and we can dive in?
Yeah, absolutely. So Benchmark 4 is about linking curriculum learning to careers. So it basically states that young people should understand the relevance of STEM subjects to careers, and that all teachers should be linking the importance of English and maths in their subjects. What it means in reality is that we know that when students understand the link between what they're learning and a future career, that they learn better and their attainment is higher. That's a massive plus. So when schools are, you know, we know that a lot of schools focus on attainment and that comes first before everything else. And, you know, if we can actually help them understand that by bringing careers to life for that subject, that you know, proof is there that their attainment will increase. It's about understanding that careers should be like a golden thread that runs through the school, that it isn't just the job of the career leader to deliver careers, that it's every single teacher's role to almost be a, you know, career teacher. And I mean, at the end of the day, if young people aren't at school to learn what they need to get a career, a good job, then what are they at school for? So it is it's critical, this one, that careers is embedded across the school in every single career curriculum subject.
Yeah, I think we kind of discussed beforehand, didn't we, that we feel this is being done in school. Don't get us wrong, like, we don't think it's not happening, we know it's happening, but perhaps where schools fall down and is making it really obvious to students that this, what they're doing is linked to careers. Yeah, for example, if you as a school wanted to go through the quality and career standard or do a careers mark assessment, one of the things that they will do is they will take a group of students out and discuss where careers learning is taking part in lessons. And Ofsted may do this as well in terms of pull students out and speak to them. It's the acid test, really, because if students don't understand the program that they're going through and what they're entitled to in relation to careers, you know, that, and they understand when in a particular maths lesson they're covering a subject, this links to this particular area of employment, or you might do this there. And then if those links are obvious and explicit, if you like, then, you know, it's going to be really difficult for a student to be to understand, you know, the links when you're making them.
It's true. In fact, one of my schools had a recent Ofsted visit, and the inspector spoke to a year eight student and asked them, you know, what have you done for careers? And the year eight student said, oh, well, we haven't really done anything for careers yet. We start that in year nine. And, you know, the career leader was going, oh my God, they've done loads of stuff, but they hadn't understood that was careers. So it's so important that we flash that. This is careers light all the time. I think, you know, when we're looking at this, how can we embed careers? There's, you know, how do we deliver careers in the curriculum? There's two main ways. There's one, which is using it, treating careers as a subject in its own right. So that might be delivered through their PSHE program, or drop-down days, and that's fine. They're really useful times to deliver some things for careers. But as well as that, we really want to be encouraging career leaders and teachers to deliver careers as part of their lesson. So, I know a lot of teachers go, oh, God, you know, we haven't got time. The curriculum is so jam-packed. We haven't got time to take time out to deliver careers. And really, it's understanding the opportunities to get, for example, to link this to Benchmark 5 and get employers in to deliver what they're already delivering. So an example of a school who's asked me to help them find somebody who works on the sea defences at Skegness, because they're they're covering sea defences in geography. So, you know, it's not aside from the curriculum. This is just delivering a bit of that curriculum, but with a real job, somebody who's really doing that job that can say, you know, this that you're learning, this is my job and this is how it works in reality. So, you know, easy ways of embedding employer engagement in the curriculum, which I think is, you know, a brilliant way of linking careers to curriculum, is lesson starters. So, you know, could you ask every single teacher to identify just one opportunity to bring an employer in as a lesson starter, just 15 minutes at the start of a lesson to say, oh, you're learning about trigonometry. Here's how I use it. I'm a, you know, a structural engineer and this is how I use it. It kills two birds with one stone, could be also LMI, couldn't it? Could be benchmark two.
Definitely.
But it really brings what they're learning really to life. And they, as soon as, you know, how many times have you heard young people, I mean, I hear my daughters all the time saying, I don't even know why I'm learning this. I'm never going to use this. And if we can actually, you know, help them see that this is used in the real world, in the world of work, they will understand it more. So I sort of challenge teaching staff to find the trickiest bit of their curriculum, the stuff, you know, the bit that students just do not get, and find, and, you know, bring an employer in who uses that to actually deliver that bit of the curriculum learning through the eye of the world of work so that they can see that link. And, you know, that's an easy way of embedding careers in a real way. It also will totally meet benchmark five. So if they do that, if every teaching staff just identifies one opportunity, job done.
definitely.
In a meaningful way as well.
I'm just, as well as that, I've had one of the best examples that I have. I mentioned this to pretty much most of my schools that I work with, is the careers logo idea, and having that as a prompt. So for example, you might even get a group of students to design the school careers logo that you can put on the website. But the main reason for it is to put it on your teacher's PowerPoint slides. Whenever there is going to be a reference to careers education or careers or outcomes in relation to jobs and employment, because, you know, again, we talked about making these links more obvious and more explicit. If the students understand what that logo is, when, you know, the teacher moves onto that slide, they are all automatically going, oh, here comes a reference in relation to employment or careers. So, it, you know, automatically they are prepared to see or to hear about an example of how that could be used. And likewise, it will act as a really good prompt for the teacher to, oh, this slide's come up, that, you know, that gives me the prompt to mention this particular thing or to give a task associated with careers or whatever. I think that is just a really, really easy, good example.
It is. And you know, you're right. It becomes clear that for the young people to say, God, this is about careers. But I think another important thing is, you know, with that in mind, is it then provides a bit of an impetus or a catalyst for faculty meetings to say, we need to build into our scheme of work something careers links. We've got to make sure that it's built in. So when they're designing their schemes of work, to actually look for opportunities to embed careers into the curriculum. And there's tons and tons of support and resources to help teachers. So, you know, again, I'll refer to the amazing Apprentice website, but STEM, you know, the STEM website has got actual real life lessons for teachers to use. It's got small things to embed, loads of resources. And you know, looking at resources, I want to encourage schools to use the STEM ambassador network. Some use it a lot, some haven't really used it very much at all, but, you know, there is so much help and support there. There are hundreds and hundreds of really inspiring STEM ambassadors who want to come and do those curriculum link little learning sessions. They can deliver a whole lesson. They can do a lesson starter. They can provide projects and tasks. And so I'll make sure that we give the email address, you know, for Joe, who's our local ambassador regional coordinator. And she's dead keen to meet with schools.
Yeah, they've just done a project actually. I think Leslie Rollins was running it. I think it was year 12 maths.
Yeah, really good.
And they basically had employers look at the curriculum in relation to year 12 maths and got employers into sessions to support the delivery. And I think, you know, that is just one example. And I think I would love next year to have an employer potentially look at like a subject scheme of learning and identify areas that they could slot it bits in. If you as a school did that with one department, that perhaps it was a department that was a little bit unengaged with careers.
Yeah.
You can make a link between, you can almost match an employer up with a subject area, couldn't you? And go, right, that's,
oh yeah, it, definitely. That's that.
They work with that employer around different topics,
yep.
You know, get them in. That's something that I think we're going to try.
It'd be nice,
definitely.
Yeah, I think that would be excellent. But I think that, you know, I want to really say that it's not as onerous, I think, as some teachers think. I think it's very doable.
Yeah.
And just, you know, you can start small. You can just start with one opportunity. You can start with, you know, one a year, then one a term, and then, you know, you'll really see the benefits of how bringing employers into your classroom, you know, it really is fantastic. And, you know, then in terms of embed it using sort of distinct careers time, whether it's PSHE or drop down days, to look at the resources to help you deliver some really high quality curriculum learning through careers, using those resources that we'll attach to this. But you were saying about the careers logo, that I forgot to say this, but really, really a useful tool, because this inspector that came, I was telling you about the year eight that said, I don't do anything. They said to the career leader, you know, when we're looking at this benchmark, we're really looking at what can we see and what can we hear. Yeah. And so they want to be going round the school and into classrooms and seeing careers. So they want to see posters on the wall that link their curriculum subject to careers. They want to see, you know, logos of or you know, pointers as to where the curriculum is being embedded. They want to see schemes of work where there's a clear link to careers.
Mm.
And they want to hear it. So they want to speak to students and hear what they've got to say about what they've learned about careers. So really is important that we make it explicit, really explicit.
Yeah. And again, we keep doing this, but we're bringing it back to the Gatsby One to an extent. It's almost creating an ethos, isn't it, within school around on this particular subject. And again, it'll link with Gatsby 3, Gatsby 2, they all kind of pull together. You know, if you can create that ethos and that momentum around the subject of careers and get people talking about it, and it becomes a habit then, doesn't it? And within lessons, you know, teachers are talking about it at regular intervals. You know, all of a sudden you see everything come together as a package then, I guess, of kind of careers advice and guidance. And
it does. It becomes a culture.
Yeah,
and that's what we want. We want careers to be part of the culture. You know, and it might be that one way forward is to ask teaching staff, you know, is there anyone that actually wants to step up as one as a career ambassador, as a career champion, maybe someone from each faculty that can take this on board and can look for opportunities to bring careers into that subject.
And I guess a couple of other challenges that I've come across as well is, you know, sometimes as a careers leader, it can be what you feel feels a bit of a lonely role, can't it?
Yeah.
Or at least some of my careers feel a bit on their own and perhaps don't have that support from senior leadership team. And I guess we've not covered that yet, but we would really encourage you to find a link governor within the School of Governors that can really, you know, be on your side, be in your team. And I think that's one of the things I talk about a lot with my schools, is to build the team around you. So you can't just be on your own and you can't do it yourself. So if you can have a link governor that you work with regularly. So one of the schools I've worked with has now accessed their link governor. They're going to meet together to try and find some things that they can work on together. You've got your enterprise advisor.
Yeah.
If you find faculty leader that wants to be involved, and then you've got a group of students that perhaps there as well, perhaps a parent board, like almost like a parent board that you can sound things, and all of a sudden your voice as a careers leader starts to get louder and starts to, it allows you to make more traction and get more.
Absolutely. We've sort of talked about in some of the other benchmark, you know, benchmark one, we really need to be having the voice of the governors in that. Benchmark two, you know, your governors are a brilliant source. They're a fantastic source of LMI. And I think doing that regular, you know, if you're doing a regular commentary after every compass evaluation and after you've done your destination data, you know, ask for a slot at the governor's meeting so that you can present that, because those we have got to try and get this more embedded at a senior level. That support's so important. I mean, in terms of where to go from here, I think the first thing to do is to find out what's already happening. As we've already said, we know stuff is, but sometimes the career leader says, I didn't even know they were doing that in that lesson. So there's a really good careers in the curriculum audit that we'll put a link on to. I'd really, really encourage you to send that round to every teaching staff to ask them, how are they currently embedding careers in their subject? You'll be probably really pleasantly surprised, and you know, we'll find that you'll be able to positively affect your compass evaluation when you find out what's going on. Yeah. But where there are massive gaps, where not much is happening at all, you can work with that faculty to find easy, quick, but really meaningful ways to embed careers in the curriculum. So I think that audit is a really useful first port of call. And, you know, we're happy to come and do some CPD session for teachers to help them make it easy to embed careers in their subjects.
Good stuff. I think that was probably one of the longer videos, because we like that one, don't we?
It's our favourite one.
Right, Debs, catch you in the next one.
See you, thanks. Bye-bye.